Welcome back and hello if you're new. So this week I'm going to be talking about what is potentially one of the most influential bands in metal, full stop. Sadly, Chuck Schuldiner was taken from us at far too young of an age. However, this month marks the 25th anniversary of the absolutely astonishing fifth album, Individual Thought Patterns. So Individual Thought Patterns is potentially one of Death's most significant records because of the element of technicality in it. Obviously, later on would come Symbolic and The Sound of Perseverance, which a lot of people believe is Death's most progressive record. I've always found that Individual Thought Patterns is their most technical record. It's also the only record to feature Andy LaRocque on guitar, and the first to feature Steve DiGiorgio and Gene Hoglan. It's really interesting because obviously it's sandwiched between Human and Symbolic. So the element of progression that was in Human and in terms of both lyrics and musicality has been heightened. There were elements of more experimental nature coming through, for example, the acoustic section in Destiny. That sort of keyboard section on Mentally Blind, you know, you could say that that was following on from the tail end of Human. But you could also put it the other way and say that there are even elements that foreshadow that sound that the band would get into Symbolic. Or that quintessential melancholic sound on The Philosopher. But of course, one of the biggest additions was Gene Hoglan. On this album, you can really feel that strength behind the drum kit. Steve DiGiorgio carves out his own path, which it's almost kind of, I feel, has a bit of a resurgence now. For example, bands like Beyond Creation, where the bass is almost an instrument in itself. But Steve DiGiorgio, you know, you could say was a pioneer in that. But you can hear it, for example, in Nothing Is Everything, where the man sort of has his own walking bass lines. But just as much as the band may be technical, there's still that classic Death groove. For example, the section in Human Form. And again, on the opening track, Overactive Imagination. But as I mentioned, this is very much a technical album, and there are some absolutely incredible technical moments throughout this record. For example, the verse of Trapped in a Corner has got all of these sort of like switching up rhythms. And the track itself, Individual Thought Patterns, is full of these technical flourishes that the band employed. And although Gene Hoglan may smash the drums to pieces, there's also an element of jazz, particularly in Trapped in a Corner, for example. And of course, there are some absolutely incredible solos from both Schuldiner and LaRocque. And one of my favourite solos in Death's catalogue is Trapped in a Corner. But then again, you know, you've got those huge anchored riffs on Mentally Blind, for example, which has just got that sort of Individual Thought Patterns was, like I mentioned before, sandwiched between Human and Symbolic. So in terms of Death reaching that evolution that would eventually become symbolic and the sound of perseverance. Indirectly, you could argue that they did somewhat spawn the idea of technical death metal with this album. And 25 years on, it still sounds just as fresh as it did back in 1993. And I think that is really what Death's coup de grace is. And if you're a death metal fan and you've not listened to Individual Thought Patterns, please, please check it out. Relapse are reissuing a special anniversary edition on vinyl and t-shirts, all this sort of stuff. Make sure you go out and pick it up because it's absolutely phenomenal. So thank you for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, hit that like and subscribe button. You can also subscribe over to my channel, The Metal Triss. Tell me what you thought of Death's Individual Thought Patterns. Is it one of your favourite albums? Are you not too keen on it? And I'll see you guys next week for another Apocalyptic Anniversaries. Alright, see you later.